confessed your sins, you've stopped doing them, you've accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. When you do that, you get the Holy Ghost is with you to guide and direct you into all truth. However, you are not filled with Him. You have a portion of Him with you. But it's entirely different than being filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. That is entirely different.
They did breathe on them and said, receiving the Holy
Ghost. I'll be honest, brother, that's a whole other can of worms, and we're not going there. Because there's so much debate over that one.
Fill you with the Holy Spirit. He should give you, fill you with the Holy Spirit. It's kind of hard for me to comprehend.
Well, like I said, at salvation, we get a portion of the Holy Ghost, but you're not filled with the Holy Ghost.
Well, how do you know you're 100% filled with the Holy Spirit?
To be honest, the person who has tongues has to keep going back for a new fresh touch and a fresh filling. It's not a once and done thing. Every day.
You're saying the Holy Spirit can leave you.
He can't. He's with you. He's
not going to leave you. He's with you all the time.
But there's a difference between Him being with you and being in you. What's this now?
Okay, I got what you're saying. He's with you on the outside trying to guide you or mentally. You're talking to me, He's trying to guide you mentally?
Yes.
Or by your heart. But when you're filled, then when He enters into your body, that's when you speak tongues. Is that what you're saying? I'm confused.
In essence, yes. In us. But there are two different, but it's the gift of God. It's an entirely different situation. But for the sake of time, we're going to wrap up here.
So to study that, you're talking Ephesians 1, 13 and 14.
That is where we have, it's the earnest of our inheritance. It's not a filling, it's just a small portion to go with us. It's just saying that what I say is true, and you can take that to the bank, basically. Does everybody have the survey that was on the back table there? And does anybody need a pen? I will leave the room and give you guys time to fill out. What it's basically doing is I want to know if there's anything that you think needs to be changed at Sunday school, anything different you want to have done. Also, when it comes to our next Bible series, what do you want to study? What topics do you want to study? When it comes to Easter, how do you want to approach the Easter account? Do you want to look at it through prophecy? Do you want to look at it through Psalms 22, 3, 24? How do you want to study the Easter account? It's something that we study every year, but how do you want to study it this year? And so my presence not here to hinder, I am going to walk to the back. Did you have questions, Paul? Oh, you're done. And then if you just want to leave them on the communion table back here, I'll get them after Sunday school.